I wanted to make this video to show to my friend Jason, who I consider a Korean patriot and who I met some years ago while visiting Korea. This is the story of Park Hee-byung, another Korean patriot who came much earlier, an independence activist and one of the first Korean men in the U.S. state of Colorado. Park was born in 1871 in the province of Gangwon-do. At that time, it was one united province, but nowadays it's separated between North and South Korea. By 1894, he graduated from the Royal English Academy, and from 1895, he studied at the Koryu University in Japan, before moving on to the Roanoke College in Virginia, where he studied with Prince Yi Kang, fifth son of Emperor Gojong. By now, he knew flawless English and had been instilled with American and Japanese philosophies and had ideas of statehood in his mind. From 1899, he returned to Korea to establish the Wonsan gold mine in Yongbyon, and there it was that he created an academy. From this hardy mining community he helped establish in his homeland, he recruited patriots to send to Denver. There they would raise money for the Korean independence movement and form the nucleus for the recognition of the state of Korea. However, he soon heard of the plight of his people in Mexico. From 1905 to 1906, he took part in a special investigative envoy to Mexico to uncover a slave labor operation targeting Korean men. Before moving to Denver, however, he was ordained a missionary. When he settled in Colorado, he established a dorm and an office for Koreans interested in independence and aligned himself with the Korean independence movement. In 1905, he established the Provisional Government Overseas Office for the Republic of Korea. He and his nephew planned to campaign at the 1908 Democratic National Convention, which at the time was more aligned with conservative and religious values, but was assassinated in 1907. His case remains very mysterious, and no names to my knowledge were ever put forward as suspects. Because of the complicated nature of the case, the ambivalence towards Korea at the time, and Colorado's more or less overlooked status in U.S. politics in the early 1900s, the case was never solved, and may not have even been investigated. He was buried in an unmarked grave. In 2003, Korean patriots finally found records showing where he was buried. The local Korean American Association organized a ceremony in 2007 that erected a granite tombstone. Attending the event were 50 people, including Korean Consul General Koo Ban-woo. It's important that we put these Korean patriots to rest, and this man himself, I believe, deserves a mausoleum in Korea. It's important that we remember the patriots that came before us, as well as acknowledge the work of the patriots that are already operating in Korea today.